Today I'm gonna make a 3-cell lithium battery pack using these 18650 cells, and I'm going to put it in the Tanner airplane just to see how long we can fly with these batteries. These are very popular and it's gonna be very interesting.
And I'm going to put the flight controller in the Tanner, and this is just to facilitate the telemetry data from the voltage, also to smooth the flight, and maybe use the GPS to automate the flight. Let's see if that's possible. I also connected this tiny receiver using Express LRS, which is long range using 2.4 GHz, and this is the GPS, tiny, but it should be good enough. The only thing is that it doesn't include the magnetometer, so I don't have a compass, and let's see if that works. So to mount a flight controller, I'm going to use these plastic standoffs, and then I'm going to use rubber shock absorbers or anti-vibration to keep the flight controller very smooth. This flight controller is very old and limited. I don't have a magnetometer or altimeter, but I only need the stabilization and the telemetry to be able to read the voltage of the airplane battery on my radio. I open a small hole at the bottom of the fuselage to put the antenna out and keep up good reception. Now I have to set up the software, INF, and I'm not going through the whole process because I've done that in a previous video. I'll leave the link in the description below. Instead, let's focus on what we're here for. The batteries. As you can read in the label of the battery, these batteries can be very dangerous, so just be very careful when handling batteries, especially when building a battery pack like I'm doing now. So please understand that this is not a tutorial, I'm doing this at my own risk, but if you still want to make your own battery packs, it's at your own risk, and I'll leave some recommendations in the description below. Okay, with that out of the way, I'm going to start making my first battery pack using lithium 18650 cells. To be specific, I'm using cells from LG. Each one have a capacity of 2500 mAh and you can discharge them at 20 amps. I decided to buy these ones because they're very cheap and they have good characteristics for what I want to do. This is my first attempt anyways, so it's going to be good enough. Of course, there are several options in the market, like this Sony Murata, which can hold 2800 mAh and you can draw up to 35 amps of power. Or if you're looking to store more energy, you can use this one that has 3400 mAh of energy capacity. But as you can see, they cost a little bit more. So I'm going to start with my endeavor of modifying the nose of the airplane to fit these batteries. By the way, the Tanner is available for purchase at joyplanes.com. It's a great kit if you want to start in the hobby, it's all balsa wood, and of course you can modify it just like I'm doing now for whatever reason you want. Check the description below for more information. So before I used to put some weights in the nose of the aircraft to balance it, but now I'm opening some space to place a 3S LiPo battery in there. This one is 1.3 amp hours, and that way I don't need the weights anymore. In this same space, I will fit the lithium battery pack that I'm going to make. Okay, I'm gonna get ready to make the battery pack. First, I'm going to show you all the things that I'm going to use to make it. First is a spot welder. This is not very expensive nowadays and is specifically to make these batteries. I'm not going to use soldering irons or anything like that because that could damage the batteries. I also have the nickel strips, an XT60 connector from an old battery, and the valance port as well. This is from a 3S old battery that was dead, so that's perfect. Of course, you can buy these connectors separately as well. And this high temperature resistant tape is very handy. The process is very straightforward. I'm going to take a piece of nickel strip and round the edges and place it on top and just weld the two surfaces. So to make the 3S, it's very simple. We just connect the batteries in series and that way we get the sum of the voltage of each cell. Again, what I'm doing here is not professionally made, it should be done better, but to save some weight and space, I just decided to do it the old-fashioned way, using some, you know, hot glue without any spacers or anything like that. As I said, this is very straightforward, it's a 3S battery, but I just follow the path again just to make sure, positive to negative, then connected to positive, then negative to positive, so that's the one that I have to solder next. And finally, on the output terminals, I weld a nickel tap to be able to solder wires easily. Here the battery is packed together, so I test the voltage with my multimeter and it all seems right. Now I have to solder the connectors and it should be done. Batteries, lithium batteries, lithium ion makes me happy. Batteries, lithium ion makes me happy. Can charge them like LiPo batteries, but they can hold a lot more power. They are cylindrical but a bit bigger than the AA, and you can use them in your RC airplanes. And now I soldered the valence connector, which is also very easy, and you can follow this diagram to solder these connectors. Finally, I connect the multimeter to see if everything is connected very well, and the battery is ready. I'm just gonna cover it with some heat shrinking plastic, but this one is very big, so I'm gonna cut it and make it the size of this pack. And finally, I'm going to use this tape to cover any exposed metallic area of the batteries to avoid any accidents. Now I'm going to charge it using the lithium option, but you can also use the LiPo option because the final voltage per cell is the same. And now we're going out to fly the Tanner and see which battery performs the best. The whole idea of using the flight controller and the GPS was to activate the loiter mode and leave the airplane fly by itself, but it didn't work in the end and the day was very windy and what I had in mind was not possible. So I decided to go back home and do a very simple test inside the house using both batteries. First I'm testing the LiPo battery, 1300 mAh 3S, and let's see how long it lasts. So I start the test putting the throttle at 100%, then after 3 minutes and a half I put it back to 50%, I wait until 6 minutes and put it back to 100% and wait until the battery drains out. So let's see how this one performs. So after 7 minutes and a half the battery couldn't hold it anymore, I guess the battery is also a little bit old, so I would expect a battery like this one to go a little bit over 8 minutes, maybe 8 and a half minutes. And as we can see in the meter, we could only drain 1.03 amps from this battery. Now let's do the same with the lithium ion battery and let's see the results. The procedure I did was exactly the same, starting with 100% throttle, then at 3.5 minutes going back to 50%, then wait until 6 minutes and go back to 100% until it drains out. But when it reached 10 minutes of 100% throttle, I decided to put the throttle back to 75% and see how long it will last from that mark on. It reached around 18 minutes and a half until the voltage was very low and the total amp hour consumption was 2.35, which is very similar to the 2.5 amp hour capacity of the battery. Of course, you cannot get the whole capacity of the battery because you need to leave some juice in the battery, otherwise it will be damaged. Actually, at this point, I'm at the edge of damaging the battery because I'm trying to extract a little bit more power, but the voltage is going down too quick. So for me, that's an absolute success. And here I'm trying to get the last drops of power from the battery, but I'm just going to damage it. So I'm gonna stop now. Now let's measure the weight of both batteries because that's a very important factor. The LiPo battery weighs only 124 grams, and the lead-ion battery weighs 154, which is 30 grams more. And 30 grams more is not a lot actually, especially if you're getting a lot more power capacity, which was in this case 3 times more endurance than the LiPo battery.
2.5, 2.7, 2.6.
In this case, because the lead-ion battery has each cell at a lower voltage than a LiPo battery would have, well, I have to use the lead-ion program on the charger to handle those low voltages. So there you have it, lithium-ion batteries are the winner. Of course, that depends on the application you're going to use them for. For example, if you need a very fast and aggressive racing drone, you're going to use the lithium polymer batteries, which will give you the most amount of power in the least amount of time. Well, this was an interesting project. Remember to subscribe, and I'll see you in the next project.